it's Donna Briggs, and today is Talk About It Tuesday. I hope you had a spectacular week. Yes, it's only Tuesday, but I know you said your affirmations yesterday. I live in abundance. I'm wealthy. I'm healthy. My family's healthy. I'm prosperous. I'm positive. No negativity will come near me, around me, or against me. That's what you did. Every morning you say that, and you live amazing, fabulous life like me. Anyway, today is Talk About It Tuesday. Yay! Wait a minute. You can see through this. I don't like this. I don't like that. I gotta change. But anyway, so today's Talk About It Tuesday. And today we're gonna talk about goals. Goals, goals, goals. What are your goals? Do you have any goals? And if you have goals, do you have to persuade yourself every morning to get up to reach your goal? If you do, that's not the goal for you. That's not the goal for you. It's just not. Because your goal should be something you enjoy doing. It shouldn't seem like work. And some people's minds, most people have the mindset that obtaining your goal, you have to focus on the how. Don't focus on the how. I never focus on it. I'm telling you. If something's for you, the doors are going to open. Like when I started doing radio, perfect example. I did a little small radio show on internet radio. Who even listens to internet radio? I did that. I met somebody at the post office. Now, I started a internet radio show, right? This is how stuff happens, goals. When you have goals, the doors open fast if it's for you. If it's for you to do, you're not going to have, it's not going to be a struggle for you to do it. That's the indication. If you're doing something and that's your goal and you're struggling to do it, you hate getting up doing it, it's not fun, someone's persuading you to do it, like your mom, your dad, your sister, your brother, it's not for you. I started this internet radio show, right? Then, maybe 30 days later, no exaggeration, I'm at the post office, I'm in line, this guy's trying to talk to me, I'm like, whatever. But something told me, just take his card, whatever. And I was still doing the real estate stuff, but not really, but kinda. And I took his card, he called me, he's like, did you even look at my card? I'm like, no. I said, guys give me cards all the time. Whatever. He said, go to your purse and look at my card. I said, okay, I'll look at it. I looked at his card. It said, senior programmer for CBS Radio. What? Okay. He said, wow, I checked out your internet radio show. This is goals. Now, I had, like, I'm going to do a radio show. This is when I met Larry King. So, the next day, I started an internet radio show. That's the backstory. The next day, because I listen to what people say, especially if they have experience and they know things. That's another thing about goals. If someone comes in your path and they've been there, done that, listen to them. Don't sit there and be like, oh, I know everything. I'm going to do it on my own. And I'm going to figure it out on my own. No. He knew. He said, you know what, Donna? Get a radio show. That next day, I went to Blog Talk Radio, start a radio show. 30 days later, I was in line at the post office. The guy who was a senior programmer at CBS saw me, saw my radio show. He Googled my radio show because I said in line, oh, I'm doing this little radio show. It's not a big deal. You know, whatever. I really liked it. I think we can hire you at CBS. What? CBS? I'm like, okay. So boom, I was on CBS. Then Clear Channel called me. Then Radio 1 called me. So then I had a show on Clear Channel, a show on Radio 1, and a show on CBS. Three shows. And this is in within 6 months. Fast. Doors open. Boom, 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 boom. Fast, fast, fast. That's how that's what happens when your goals are aligned of what you're supposed to be doing. Then next thing you know, I got a phone call from Sirius coming for an interview. And they were like, oh, well, you're not really trained enough to be on syndicated radio, because I wasn't, because remember, I just started. I didn't know anything about radio. So they made me train for a year, and then I got on Sirius. But the doors opened up like that. So I'm just telling you out there, if you're listening, if you're working on something, you don't enjoy it, which I really enjoy doing that. It's fun. It's hard to do. The doors are not opening up for you. That's not for you. Here's another story. I know this girl, lady, rather, girl, whatever. She's a lawyer. She went to law school. She graduated. She's a lawyer. Now she's getting ready to be a partner. So she says, in general conversation, man, I hate this. What? So wait a minute. You're a lawyer. You went to law school. I said, so why are you a lawyer? So she says, well, my parents wanted me to be a lawyer. Wait a minute. You have to live for yourself. So she says, I think I'm going to quit and write books. I said, well, why didn't you do that in the beginning? Well, my parents didn't want me to do that. Why are you living for your parents? Stop living for other people. Live for yourself. You have to live for yourself. And that's a problem a lot of people don't do. They don't live for themselves. Me, I live for myself. Oh, it's crazy. Why are you starting a radio show? You don't know anything about radio. Oh, it's crazy. Why are you doing red carpets? You don't know anything about red carpets. Oh, it's crazy. Why are you doing real? Why? I mean, anything I do, people are like, oh, that's, oh, doesn't make any sense. Like this make every day a great day thing. That's crazy. What are you doing about? Wait till you guys see what I'm doing with that. Anyway, I'm just telling you guys out there, if it's for you, the doors will open. It's not going to be hard. It's not going to be like, oh my God. Like when I was doing TV, perfect example. I'm walking down the street. This is another true story. I'm walking down the street in New York. This guy comes over to me, gives me a card. And there's something about these business cards or whatever. Gives me a card. And he says, give me a call. So I'm saying, some guy with a card, whatever. I find the card in my purse. I call it. I'm like, it says, wait a minute, Warner Brothers? So I call this card, right? And the guy was like, you didn't call me. How come you didn't call? I'm like, people give me cards all the time. Really? And he's like, I want you to interview for this TV show. So I interview for this TV show. It was like 1,500 people there for this show, right? It's a dating show, like one of those reality TV shows. Yes, I did that too. They pick me. And I go to the interview. I go to the audition. I do my little piece that they tell me to do. And I don't really care if they call me because whatever. I don't care. So they call me and they said, oh my God, you got chosen to be on the show. I'm like, really? Oh, all right, whatever. We'll come back because it's down to the last 100 people. I'm like, okay. So I go back and then everybody's there with their agents and managers. And they're like, well, where's your agent? Where's your manager? I don't have a manager. I don't have an agent. How did you get here? Oh my goodness. Like, I was walking down the street and the guy gave me a card and I called. Oh, wow. That's amazing. You're so lucky. I was like, I guess, whatever. I don't really care if they call me or not, to be honest. Whatever. So then they chose me for that and they picked me. What? I didn't care. Wow. And they gave me $3,200. To go on a date with this guy and act like I like him. Like, I can do that for a date. Like, okay. $3,200 for a date for an hour? I can do it. But the caveat was, you cannot have a copy of the show because Warner Brothers own the show. And you don't get any royalties from the show. That's what made me start filming my own stuff. You're like, oh, shit. All my footage you see me with, all those celebrities, I own the footage. And because of that happening with Warner Brothers is why I own my own footage. So I learn from my mistakes. So I learn from stuff that comes up. A lot of people don't learn. They go through things. They don't learn anything. But I learn from stuff that happens to me. But anyway, that's why I own my own footage. So all those celebrity interviews you see me with, I own the footage. I own my own media company. I own the footage because if someone else films it with their camera, they own the footage and you don't have the rights to it. Keep that in mind. So if you have something and you want to keep it, own the camera, own the film. because they will say, hey, we own the camera, we own the film, and you don't have the rights to it. Anyway, that's all about goals. That's today's Talk About It Tuesday. It's about goals. If it's for you out there, the doors are going to open up for you. Stuff is going to happen. Something's going to come up to you. Things are going to happen for you in your favor. It's not going to be some hard struggle. It's not going to be, oh my God, I've been working my goals for like 10 years. I've been trying to sing for 15 years. I've been trying to be a rapper since I was 18 and you're 45. That's not for you, okay? It's not. Maybe that's not your calling, okay? Anyway, I love you guys. Make every day a great day. And remember, all goals aren't for you. If you have a struggle with it or if it's a problem, maybe you should pursue other interests. I love you, I love you, love you. Make every day a great day. Stay in positivity, stay faithful, stay kind, stay loving. And remember, we're all in this together, and stay positive out there. I'll see you tomorrow on Wisdom Wednesday. Bye.